Welcome to this presentation from the Wisconsin First Detector Network. This video was adapted from a Wisconsin First Detector Network training session. In this video, you'll hear Brian Hudelson from the Plant Disease Diagnostic Clinic talk about Verticillium wilt.
In terms of other diseases that we see quite commonly, Verticillium wilt is a very common one. I'm going to be talking about Dutch elm disease a little bit later on, and that's kind of related in many ways to this disease. Both of these are vascular wilt diseases where the pathogen gets into the water conducting tissue in the plant and blocks it off. The bad thing about Verticillium is that it has such a huge host range, and as compared to Dutch elm disease, which is pretty much strictly in elms. With Verticillium, you can see it in things like redbud, you can see it in maple trees, a variety of maples. About the only maple I don't see it in very commonly is silver maple, and you can also see it in things like, if you're growing a vegetable grower, probably the best indicator plant, quite frankly, for this organism is eggplant. And if you're concerned about this being a problem on a property, what I would suggest would be to plant some eggplants as indicator plants, because they will show these kind of intervenal sorts of symptoms very easily, and then eventual wilt and death. This is a fatal disease. And the reason I'm concerned about this one is certainly in ornamentals, we continue to find what are potentially new hosts. Within the past couple of years, we found four potential new hosts, and so we do need to be watching native plants to see whether or not we're seeing this more commonly on those types of plants. But it's a very destructive disease, particularly in urban settings. And if you have any thought of taking what I call municipal mulches, those are the chipped up street trees, and using those anywhere near a natural area, I would not do that. There's potential for moving this organism around in those sorts of mulches. Sugar maple certainly is susceptible, and we do have a few red buds further south in the state. Certainly that's a great host for it. So it's got a huge host range, hundreds and hundreds of different plants. And it's not only woody ornamentals, it's also herbaceous plants as well. And this is how you get a hold of me if you have any questions.
Thanks for watching this video from the Wisconsin First Detector Network. To learn more about our network or to access additional information about invasive species in Wisconsin, please visit our website or contact us.